This is the 2019 Nissan Altima, fully redesigned for this model year throughout. And let's jump into the perks, quirks, and irks. Big news here is it's the first Nissan sedan to offer standard all-wheel drive. Looking up front, I love the deep V-Motion grille, very nice and aggressive look. I've got the top trim Platinum Edition. So my day runners, my lights, and my fog lights are LEDs. Turn signals happen to be halogen still. And they say they've got a muscular hood. It's redesigned and it's nice and it's got some cool contours. I wouldn't quite say it is muscular, so kind of quirky there. You'll notice that there's a lot of the boomerang design in here. So it's there, it's there, it's there, it's there, it's there. I guess maybe the bottom corner of the V-Motion grille is a little on the boomerang-esque side as well. 19-inch wheels come on this top trim. 16s and 17s come with the other two trims. They say it's a knife-like design for this specific rim. I don't really see it myself. Cool design, I don't really see the knife-like aspect to it. A little irk for me as far as needing things to be symmetrical. That handle is lower, that handle is higher. I just don't like it. I wish there were just one level. Floating roof, there's that little black patch right in the middle that separates the roof from the body, so it kind of gives a cool look right there. Give you a bit of a closer look at it. There we go. And let's go around the rear end of the boomerang motif right there. Twin tailpipes, look sharp, nice conservative rear of the vehicle. I like that there's orange turn signals. I wish they were LED, but halogen isn't all that bad itself. Let's take a look at the trunk. One push up, there you go. 436 liters of cargo space, I believe. You can drop the seats, 60-40 split. There's one for the driver's side, there's one for the passenger side. But if you pull it, it doesn't go down. It just unlatches it and you've got to go around to the front of the car, or the side of the car, sorry, and let the seats down yourself. But good space nonetheless. Couple of magazine boxes and summer mats. So let's close that up and we'll be right back with a look at the inside of the 2019 Nissan Altima. Taking a look at the rear seats of the new Altima, I had pre-popped the seats in the first part of the video. I'm gonna grab the headrest, pull down. That's what your 40% split looks like. Your armrest turns into two cup holders. Very nice. Close that up. Fixed headrests. And the cool thing here is you have a USB and a USB-C port. You have the same thing up front. We'll get to that. We'll get to that right now. One touch unlock and lock right there. Doesn't have it on all four doors, just the front two. So that's what your cabin looks like if you're about to get into it, which we are. You get your memory seats, buttons are there. Very nice finish here, leather, nice soft touch, nice little bit of chrome accents there. I like that. Driver's seat, the cool thing here is on all trims it's an 8-way power seat. So if you want to go on the base trim, you don't get penalized for having a manual seat. Very nicely done there. Irk, start stop button is there. Not a big fan. I would rather it be there where it's supposed to be. So flat bottom steering wheel, easier for ingress egress. So you can just see my knee sliding there as opposed to if I turn the wheel like that, it gets stuck. So full marks to you there, Nissan, very nicely done. It's a little warm. Let's open up part of the window. So a cool thing, and thank you so much Nissan for doing this, taking a page out of Kia's playbook. Here are my lights, and now Nissan lets you know where your lights are. And yes, it's a pretty easy thing to see, but I like that they've done it so you can know exactly where your lights are, whether it's the parking lights, regular lights, off or auto. Same thing for the wipers. Nissan, you're so good. I love this feature because sometimes you're like, well, am I on intermittent? Am I on low? Am I on high? Whatever it is, it's good to know. And with the intermittent, you can choose your intensity, obviously, but you can actually see the intensity. So I really like that. And I want my wipers off now, so up to the top and they're off. Another cool thing here is, where is it? It's under settings and it's under driver assistance. And it's under blind spot, and this is really cool. You can pick your intensity for brightness of the blind spot, which is there, it's orange, and you can go bright, standard, or dark. Like, I think that's really, really nice. I like that quite a bit. I keep it on bright, just I want to be able to see. So there's a look at the bright, there's a look at the dark. It's kind of hard to tell on camera. Well, that's a bit of a better look. Anyway, so yeah, you can choose that, and I absolutely love it. Well done, Nissan. There's a bunch of other cool features that you can go through with your settings right there. So very cool, Nissan, well done. They also have the, as I keep going through this, come on, the rear cross traffic alert and driver attention alert. You can put those on or off as well. Anyways, moving on, all sorts of information there. Nice standard dials, pretty easy to pull out all your information. Ton of digital information as well. A couple of controls there. Thank you for leaving me zero blank switches. You know how much I like that, Nissan. Well done. Let's get rid of that. So there's your infotainment system. Fairly easy to use. Sorry, not center. There's your infotainment system. Easy to use, easy to navigate. Very, very nicely done. Nice and clean. You can do whatever it is that you want and that you need to. Still kind of hard because there's no actual phone button. Yes, I know there's a phone button there, but if I just wanted a quick touch button, I would have liked it to be there instead of there. A bit of a faux wood trim. Goes all across there. Not really the greatest thing, for me anyway. There's a touch of it there. Interestingly, there's the kind of hard piano black finish there, and it's got like specks and sparkles in the design as well. And it's only there and there. So, full marks for making it look kind of cool. There's your ProPilot Assist. I'll link to that video at the end of this one. Pretty standard stuff here. You can your USB, USB-C controls, couple of cup holders, my notes. Your parking brake and your auto hold. It's a pretty comfortable cabin. The driver's seat, which I will show you again, because I missed it the first time. Side bolster is great. Thigh bolster is great. Doesn't have any extender here, but it's a really comfortable seat. Nissan's got their zero gravity stuff happening, and that's quite nice as well. Sunroof, not panoramic, but sunroof nonetheless, and it's standard on the platinum trim. You got your sunglasses holder there and your light banks there as well. I really like that the HVAC controls are so easy to use. You want it on, you want it off. It's so intuitive. It's so easy. You got your dials, you got your buttons, you got your display. Nicely done. And even nicer than that is your heated seats and your heated steering wheel controls right there. Impossible to miss. So well designed. Full marks to you on that, Nissan. Anyways, that's going to wrap up the inside. It's a very, very comfortable ride. I've had it for, I think, 7 days now. And it's been great. I mean, I've been stuck in traffic. I've been doing highway speeds, and there haven't been any issues with it for me. So interior fit and finish, very nice. Oh, this also has the 9-speaker Bose system. There's a little logo. Let's take a closer look. There we go. 9-speaker sounds great. We'll be right back with a little more on the 2019 Nissan Altima. I'm going to show you how the rear seat alert works. I don't have any kids. Well, I have a guitar. It's kind of like a kid. So I'm going to put it back there. Go up to the front of the car. Put the car in drive. So right now, before I go anywhere, it says rear door alert is activated, dismiss or disable alert. I'm going to keep it on. I'm going to go up a few feet, put the vehicle in park, shut the vehicle off, get out of the vehicle. I'm going to lock the doors. So 6 horn honks saying, hey, you left someone or something in the rear seats. Don't forget it. Go back and get it. So yeah, very cool feature there, Nissan. No more forgotten guitars for me or groceries or whatever it is. Drive portion 2019 Altima. Power wise, we've got a 2.5 liter engine, 4-cylinder, 182 horsepower, and a very closely matched 178 pound feet of torque, all run through a CVT. No paddle shifters, no sport mode, just straight up and down. Really, really like that about the Altima. Very, very quiet cabin, and it kind of has that premium feel to it. The seats are incredibly comfortable. It's got that Nissan zero gravity seat, so long road trips should not be any kind of an issue here. Creature comforts, everything's within reach, everything's smartly placed as well. Can't get over how much I like the wiper graphic that tells you which stage your wiper's in. Same thing with your headlights as well. We went over that on the in-car portion of the review. As far as driving dynamics go, it's a sedan, it's all-wheel drive. I was in Quebec for the launch and there was a bunch of snow. But as far as Canadian winters go, this will be the first true test in a few months from now. I guess a little more than a few. It's May, middle of May, so the all-wheel drive will definitely help out with Canadian winters. So I'm happy that Nissan has brought that to market. Not a lot of oversteer, not a lot of understeer. Decent amount of pickup. It's a sedan. This is not a performance sedan by any means. It's meant to be a very smooth, well-designed, premium feeling vehicle from Nissan, and if that's what they're after, which is what I think it is, they've done a terrific job of putting this together. Easy to park, not a lot of blind spots, and you have the standard rear view camera. Let's take a look at that now. We'll run a light. That's your regular backup camera, and just over to the right is the surround view camera, which is what comes with the top trim platinum edition, which is what I have. I don't really have any problems with the vehicle, you know, again, keeping in mind what kind of class of vehicle it is and who it's designed for. The seats are comfortable, as I said. There's lots of room in the trunk for whatever it is that you need. The seats go down for even more space. And I like it because it's really, really quiet, and it's something that I wasn't really expecting from Nissan. You know, I wasn't expecting a loud vehicle on the inside. I was just pleasantly surprised at how quiet they've made the interior. And you know, pair that with the wonderful 9-speaker premium Bose sound system, and you really have a great place to spend some time. Again, as I mentioned, not a lot of oversteer, not a lot of understeer. The car does very well on city streets, does very well on the highway, sorry. And you know, fuel efficiency wise, we're at 8.1 combined. Now that's for the platinum trim. You go down to the, I believe it's the S or the SL, and fuel economy goes down, I think it's 7.9 combined. You get your safety features as well, blind spot monitoring, lane keep assist. So if I go over the line, I guess I didn't catch it this time. Anyways, there was a little buzz maybe 10, 15 seconds ago that let me know that I was slightly over the line. So nice feature there, Nissan. And you know, I'm happy with the car. If I was gonna get one, I would go with Top Jam as far as the Platinum, because it gives me the safety features, gives me the premium audio system, and I don't know, it's like, that's the way I like my vehicles. If I were to get one, the only exception as far as how I spec my vehicles, the Nissan Micra, I would get that. The S trim, which is their entry level trim, just I know that's a fun car, but anyways, that's a different review. Different review. You know, like usual, we're gonna keep that little flub in. Anyways, that's gonna wrap up the driving portion. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to subscribe. Any questions on the 19 Altima, please let me know, and I will do my best to answer them. These endings are great. All right, thanks for watching, everybody.